welcome you to the Jimmy V Women's Classic presented by Corona. This afternoon in Austin, Texas, number 11 UConn taking on the number 10 Texas Longhorns from the Moody Center. As we welcome you courtside, hey everybody, Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. So happy to be with you on a very special day for all of us here at ESPN. You just saw that moving open to our broadcast, and we will remind you throughout the afternoon that you can donate to the V Foundation. All you need to do is go to v.org/donate. 100% of the money you donate today goes towards cancer research. Rebecca, as far as what will take place on the floor here today in Austin, a terrific matchup, two top 11 teams, and Connecticut led by one of the best players in the nation, who again looks like a healthy Paige Beckers.
Yeah, we got quite a backcourt matchup in this game, and for Connecticut it's going to start and end with their 5'11 guard. She leads the team in scoring at just under 21 a game, shooting 49% from the field. She's a smooth guard who can get to her spot and make the game look effortless. Also excels at this, feeding her teammates in a great spot.
You take a look at what Paige has done over the last five games. Averaged over 23 points on 51% shooting. Meanwhile, for Texas, 8-0 to start this season, and the engine of their team is Rory Harmon.
Without question, the junior guard makes Texas go on both ends of the floor. She excels at getting into the paint, and when she gets there, she can score or distribute. 7.5 assists a game is 6th in the country. A menace defensively, Ryan. 3 steals per game.
You take a look at the assist to turnover ratio, best in the nation when it comes to players who have at least 20 assists. Texas led by Vic Schaefer in his 4th season at the helm of Texas. Last year's Big 12 Coach of the Year. He's had a whole lot of success already here with the Longhorns, and Gino Auriemma in his 39th season leading the 11-time national champion Connecticut Huskies. And here we are underway at Moody Center with Texas winning the tip. Here's Harmon. Rory Harmon will orchestrate everything for Texas. Shaylee Gonzalez. Now Booker, an impressive freshman. He's good. On a long two, Madison Booker. Been very good to start this season.
We saw UConn starting out in a man-to-man. Ice Brady, the freshman, getting her first start of her career.
Take a look at the rest of that starting lineup for Connecticut. Of course, without AZ Fudd for the remainder of this season, without Caroline Ducharme right now. Here is Brady. Brady spinning and gets denied inside by Jones. Out of bounds, going to stay here with Connecticut. We've heard Gino Auriemma say multiple times to us, Rebecca, that Ice Brady is a key to this Connecticut season.
He called her earlier in the season the biggest piece to the puzzle, and she brings size to their front court. They need her to be a terrific rebounder.
Here's Griffin storming inside, couldn't finish it again. It was Jones there on the inside making a difference.
Jones, a player who could get into foul trouble previous seasons.
Booker bangs in a three.
So important for her to be able to go up and contest without getting fouls called.
And Mule and Beckers miscommunicate as Mule turns it over.
Madison Booker is a talented freshman, and when you watch this Texas team play for the first time, she absolutely just jumps off the screen. She can get to her spots. She's quick. She's explosive. Got a beautiful shot as well.
Oh, the jacket's already off, Vic Schaefer. It did not take long. He was about 20 feet out onto the floor with the jacket just stuck to one arm trying to shake it off. Harmon connects on a corner three. What a start for Texas, who has never beaten Connecticut. Here's Griffin, finds the cutter. Edwards gets the finish, plus the foul. Well, that was a tough finish from Aaliyah Edwards.
How well are things going for Texas right now? Coming into this game, Rory Harmon was 3 of 13 from the three-point line. Steps into this one confidently, able to drain it. And then the other way, Aaliyah Edwards, she didn't care that there had been some block shots in the paint already. Goes to the bucket strong.
Struggled a little bit in the Cayman Islands after getting off to a fast start this season, but Edwards obviously going to be even more relied upon for Connecticut with the injuries they've suffered. Here is Harmon finding Gonzalez. She got it. Texas is on fire from three to start this game.
Texas, a team that averages just under 4.5 threes per game.
They have three already as Brady launches it out of bounds. Right, this is a Texas team. Only 15% of their field goal attempts are from three-point range. Second lowest in Division I basketball.
The scouting report defensively against Texas is to limit their dribble penetration, their dribble drive, their ability to get into the paint and then get touches for their bigs. You play them inside out, Ryan. So for them to come out and shoot like this is extraordinary.
Here's Booker. Harmon sizing up Nika Mule. Harmon elevates and banks it in. Lori Harmon told us earlier she feels like when she gets in the paint, she is unstoppable.
Look at her frame. She is not big in terms of height, but she is strong and broad.
A 13-3 start for Texas, and Griffin couldn't handle the backdoor cut. Edwards maybe put a little too much mustard on the pass. Harmon again got to the paint to finish. Timeout, Connecticut. Texas is 6 of 6 from the floor.
This could not have been a better start for Texas. And Rory Harmon is always going to be a big part of what they do. Tough finish as she's floating. But the paint is where she makes her money.
You see those images of Jim Valvano as we have our Women's Jimmy V Classic here today in Austin. And it has already been a big day in Austin. Steve Sarkisian a moment ago, the head coach of the Texas Longhorns football team here, getting a huge ovation as it was announced earlier today. They are in the college football playoff. We'll meet Washington. You see both semifinal matchups, which will take place on ESPN on New Year's Day. Rebecca, I know you were debating heavily what the Final Four teams should be. So,
yes, we had a nuanced conversation about it this morning.
Yes, yes, we did. I did very much. We had a terrific show revealing that at noon today. Shout out to our crew handling that. And it should be two incredible matchups on January 1st on ESPN. And they have been buzzing all morning here in Austin as Edwards gets the easy layup.
So we've seen where UConn can have some success. Their points have come from Aaliyah Edwards facing up, attacking the rim.
Texas has not missed a shot yet. Here's Gonzalez. As it knocked away by Edwards, gets to Harmon. Still plenty of time to operate. Harmon fading away. She got it. Lori Harmon is now 4 for 4 from the floor.
That was really good defense by Nika Mule as well. Harmon was just able to elevate and hit with a little fade on her shot.
Harmon did not play last year in these teams' matchup, which she said was really hard for her to take. Watching that game, it was a fairly close game that Connecticut ended up winning. Mule in the mid-range, gets it to go, plus the foul. And a whistle going the other way after the basket. Ice Brady called for the foul. Basket will count. But Gina Auriemma very honest over this past week talking about the injuries that UConn has absorbed. You take a look at this season. AZ Fudd, we know another knee injury. Your heart just breaks for out for the season. Caroline Ducharme missed 248 games the team has over the last three seasons. You see a couple more of their bigs on the bench there. Janet Alalfi and Ayanna Patterson. Alalfi done for the season. And Ayanna Patterson expected back at some point as she continues to recover from a knee injury.
So without those players that we just saw on the bench, much different in terms of post-depth for Connecticut. And then without Ducharme and AZ Fudd, completely different in terms of their potency from the three-point line.
Here's Beckers, who has even more of a load to carry. Off to Edwards. Edwards spinning inside and finishing. Push the foul. Aaliyah Edwards off to a terrific start this afternoon.
This might be have to be a heavy dose for Connecticut, is getting Aaliyah Edwards the ball 15 feet and letting her go to work. The other thing we've seen them have some success with, because Texas overplays so much in the quarter court, is getting some backcourt looks. Mika Mule hit that pull-up jumper on that last possession with a little backdoor cut.
Well, one of the things Vic Schaefer talked to us about was, as great a start as Taylor Jones has gotten off to this season, he knew this was going to be a completely different test for her today going up against Aaliyah Edwards.
Yeah, it's the first time that she's really faced significant size this season.
Harmon alone again. It finally misses, keeps it alive, but Griffin hugs the rebound for Connecticut. Here comes Mule. Off to Brady, the freshman, after being hurt last season, getting her first start. Mule. Hands to Beckers. Nine to shoot. Beckers leans and hits. Paige Beckers with her first bucket of the afternoon.
And Gonzalez had switched off onto Beckers most early possessions. It was Rory Harmon on Beckers, keeping her from getting any good looks.
Here's Muhammad cradling and finishing. Vic Schaefer has been delighted by the minutes he's gotten from the sophomore forward Amina Muhammad. With Deanna Gaston hurt, it's Muhammad who slid into the starting lineup and has done a wonderful job. Gaston getting close to returning. Beckers connects on a three.
Really nice screen by Aaliyah Edwards, and Beckers read it well. Harmon got caught up just for a second, and that's all Paige Beckers needs.
So Connecticut started one of four. They're 5 of 5 since. Here's Booker. And she traveled. Texas turns it over.
Paige Beckers can get to her spots, and we talked about in the open, can make it look effortless. Here, just caught up a second late, Rory Harmon was, and Beckers so smooth.
Second Texas turnover. You're going to hear us talk about turnovers a lot today. Texas has just an absurd turnover margin. They win the turnover battle at a plus 13 per game. Number one in the nation, as you can imagine. And right there, Booker nearly forces another one. Hey, coming up, 5 Eastern on ESPN, the third game and final game of the 22nd annual Women's Jimmy V Classic. Number 16, Ohio State, takes on number 20, Tennessee. To donate to the V Foundation for Cancer Research, go to V.org. And a reminder that 100% of that money that you donate goes towards cancer research.
You talk about that turnover margin with Texas. They forced 25 turnovers a game. We've seen them since the beginning of the game. They're going to pick up in the full court. But it's even more so the way they deny and force you out in the quarter court that can be so troubling.
Shea Holly into the game off the bench for Texas. Here's Mule looking to shake free. Brady throws it away after Mule had vacated. Paige Beckers tells Brady, don't worry about that. Well, one of the things Paige talked to us about was making sure that she and the rest of her upperclassmen keep the freshmen confident. She said, this is the most fearless freshman class we've had since I was a freshman, and we need them confident because we need them to contribute with all of our injuries. As Booker can't finish, Muhammad, nice job on the glass, and draws the foul.
Aubrey Griffin doing all she can to try to box out, but just great effort by Muhammad.
Take a look at the hot shooting to start for Texas and the hot shooting right now from Connecticut. As UConn will call in their first sub, KK Arnold will come into the game.
A different look here now. This puts Aubrey Griffin at the four spot, a smaller lineup for Connecticut.
Little talk at the officiating table. I think something might have fallen on the floor, Rebecca. And it was picked up, so we can continue.
But now I want to know what it was.
I don't know that we'll ever know. We're going to have to ask Gina Cross. She's the one who picked it up. Harmon left alone, lays it in.
Great cut. Great cut. She made Mika Mule bite when she faked to the perimeter and then just cut right to the hoop.
11 points for Rory Harmon. Here's Beckers. That's going to be an offensive foul. Ika Mule whistled for the personal.
See, screen. It's the fake, though. It's just the retreat with her hands in the air. And Nika Mule's like, all right, I got to go guard her. And then Harmon went right by.
21-14, Texas in front. Number 10 team in the nation against the number 11. 11th all-time meeting between these schools. UConn is 10-0.
For this smaller lineup, it's now Paige Beckers who is on Booker.
Here's Harmon. Floats it to Muhammad, left alone, and knocks down the jumper.
Now, Texas has done a great job making Connecticut pay every time there's miscommunication for them on the defensive end.
How about Harmon's first quarter? She has 11 points and 4 assists.
Yeah, and has been playing solid, solid defense.
Here's Beckers in the corner letting it fly. No. Rebound, Texas. Booker had it, and a whistle is going to go against Connecticut. And it will be number one on Aaliyah Edwards. Now that's the other thing you always have to watch now with this squad Gina Auriemma has is foul trouble because they've been robbed of some of their depth.
In particular, Aaliyah Edwards.
Yeah.
She's one of their experienced, consistent players.
Good hands by Bransford, and it last hit Shea Holly out of bounds off of Texas.
Texas, a team that only averages 12 turnovers per game. We've seen a few here last couple minutes.
Arnold on that deflection. Here's Mule. Beckers, good position on the interior, left it short, and the rebound, Jones.
Good decision, though. Have Beckers post up the much smaller Harmon inside.
Here's Jones, facing up, rims out. Taylor Jones coming off a game in which he went 11 of 11 from the floor at a career-high 27 points. Arnold gets denied by Jones, but a foul. And free throws coming for K.K. Arnold.
And that's some of the fearlessness you were talking about from a Connecticut freshman. Vic Schaefer not thrilled with that call. I thought Jones might have had a clean block there, Ryan.
And that is number two on Taylor Jones. So Arnold will go to the line. You know, one of the other things that Gina Auriemma talked about, Rebecca, when referring to the injuries, we were speaking with him earlier today, as he said, it's tough for the kids to be confident because now they're being asked to play roles that they're not yet equipped to play. Said, so maybe those experiences, though, help us to be ready in March?
Yes.
Or down the road after in years to come for these younger players.
But certainly growing pains until then.
Yeah. Harmon, a little too strong. Rebound, Muhammad again active on the interior. Couldn't finish it. And it's knocked in the arms of Griffin. Connecticut controls. Here's Mule trying to fend off Harmon. A minute 10 remaining in this first quarter. Texas an 8-point lead. Women's Jimmy V Classic. Edwards cups, can't finish, a lot of contact, no call. Boy, it looked like Aaliyah Edwards got clobbered there. Here's Harmon. Off to Booker, she'll fire. Around and off, long rebound. Here's Arnold, has speed. Arnold dashing inside, gets blocked by Booker. And controlled for Texas. Harmon now, 3-on-1. Mule trying to disrupt. And did, Nika Mule did just enough. And the foul is called on Hadija Fai, who locks up Edwards after the rebound.
The attack by Arnold to the rim. Wow, what a great block. Booker just goes straight up and down, keeps her hands up, just the flick of the wrist at the end of it. That's how you go up to contest a shot.
We talk about the freshmen in this country and some of the unbelievable talent across the nation. Here's another one.
Yes.
Madison Booker is absolutely someone you have got to watch.
Yeah, keep your eye on Madison Booker, and her numbers might not be gaudy. She's just under 11 points a game, but this young woman can really play.
Vic Schaefer was lighting up, talking about her to us before today's game, saying, you know, wait till she starts to get it on the defensive end a little more, too. So the way she elevates, how cerebral she is, something Rory Harmon talked about as well as the leader of this Texas team, just talking about how coachable Booker is.
I love how Vic Schaefer said, once she starts to figure it out on defense, she will be a monster.
Yes.
And that's a good thing.
Yeah. 5 second difference, game and shot clock. Booker a little short on the three, kept alive by Holly, and another chance here for Texas. You see Booker, who has point guard skills at 6'1", with Harmon on the bench, will operate the point. Booker doubled and threw it off the leg of Edwards. Going to stay here with Texas. Still a little time to operate.
Nice luxury when at 6'1", and with that kind of frame, a player has point guard skills.
Not bad. And Harmon's going to come in for Gonzalez with 2.6 to go in this first. Booker. And another kickball. Keep things right here. Texas hit its first 7 shots. They have missed their last 6. Still hold an 8-point lead. Holly will inbound. Harmon has to get it off. She does. Can't hit. And that'll do it for the first quarter. Texas a 23-15 lead after 1. Paige Beckers, Rory Harmon doing their thing early.
We told you it was going to be a great backcourt battle. Paige Beckers doing what she can for Connecticut, and Rory Harmon doing all she can for the Longhorns.
Here's Brady facing up and hitting the jumper.
And that's one of the areas where she can excel, is the face-up game. She has range out to 3, has not hit it consistently yet this year, but is capable. We see Connecticut here going to a zone defense this first possession of the second quarter.
Here's Muhammad left alone again and able to hit again with that baseline jumper. Amina Muhammad has really looked good in these early minutes. You can see why Vic Schaefer is so excited by what he's seen from his sophomore. That ball thrown away. Brady trying to get after it, and it last hit Connecticut. Texas basketball. Take a look at Rory Harmon's shot chart from that first quarter.
I mean, what's remarkable is where she tends to thrive is getting touches in the paint, and we see, yes, more effective on the right-hand side of the floor. And do we even count the last heave? I think we should take that off the shot chart and the stat sheet.
Okay, I'm fine with that.
When the clock's running down, it shouldn't count.
But, you know what? That's why you have players, especially at the professional level, put it in their pockets instead of chucking it up.
Right, never should.
No, I'd be all for that. You see what Harmon did in the first quarter, averaging just under 12 points per game for the season. In the corner, Holly's 3 off the mark. And Beckers, the weak side rebound. Beckers 5 points in that first quarter. Here's Arnold. Wiggling through traffic. Back to Beckers, who Texas has given plenty of attention to early. Beckers step back 3. That would have been filthy. In and out. Here's Harmon weaving, taking, and hitting. Rory Harmon having an afternoon.
Put so much pressure on the defense with her ability to bounce in and get, either hit that pull-up, or you know she's very capable of finding open teammates if you come to help.
13 points, 5 assists already for Harmon, who when you talk to her, I mean, she's just magnetic with her personality and the way she breaks down the game as Nika Muir banks in a deep two. A 27-19 Texas lead over Connecticut. Almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter as Harmon behind the back floats it up and off. Rebound Edwards after a couple of juggles. Connecticut controls.
Connecticut back to man-to-man after that one possession of zone.
See KK Arnold, a freshman, looking back to Gino Auriemma getting the play. As he beckons her to go to the other side of the floor. Here's Arnold. Off to Brady. Bounce inside. Edwards, another layup, and Ali Edwards up to 9 points.
And after a kind of a struggle for her a little bit in the Cayman Islands over the Thanksgiving break, two games where she was not as efficient as usual, she's back to herself here so far.
Trips up Muhammad, though, and that is going to be number two on Ali Edwards. We talked about that earlier. That's the one concern you have with Edwards, and it's amplified by the lack of depth that Connecticut currently has in their front court.
And that's a foul. I mean, we see it all the time.
Yeah.
Anytime an offensive player trips on the defensive player's foot.
You run over there and tell Gino that, right?
Yeah.
Now a whistle underneath going the other way as Nika Mule celebrates. She draws the foul on Khadijah Faye. So Khadijah Faye is whistled for her second personal. And now Faye hits the deck, and it's Brady who gets hit with the foul, and that is her second. And you can see Gino Auriemma saying you can't be moving.
Well, you can be moving, you just can't run them over.
Oh, right. In life, you could be moving.
Yes.
And in basketball as well,
right.
but not when you're going to set a screen.
Right.
Booker finishes plus the foul. A chance for three for Madison Booker.
I mean, look at this kid. She is 6'1". She is strong. She can elevate. Was Arnold in her landing space? Because it looked clean up top.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe. I mean, Vic Schaefer said about Madison Booker, she may be the best passing wing player I have ever seen. And what's amazing is you see all the other skill sets that she's brought to the table, never mind the pass.
Right.
Here's Beckers trying to shake Harmon over to Arnold. Quick first step from Arnold, shovels it low, and out of the reach of Brady, but a foul. A lot of whistles early in this second as Amina Muhammad gets hit with her second personal.
Yeah, I'd like to see this again because the pass. Well, there's no foul there.
I didn't think so.
I mean, Ice Brady is diving, trying to a little push on the hip.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
That's why we love replays.
Yes.
To check ourselves. Brady wants it. Catch, fire, no. Rebound. Holly ends up with it.
Off an on-ball screen, Paige Beckers is going to draw so much attention. The screener will be open like you saw Brady there.
29-21, Texas in front. Aaliyah Moore into the game, loses the handle. Edwards alone with a loose basketball and the easy two.
Wow, that was risky because she reached in to poke that ball away. That could have been a third foul on Aaliyah Edwards. She ends up with the easy two the other way, but oof.
11 points for Edwards, who is the leading scorer for Connecticut. Here's Booker. Little jumper, too strong. Brady tips it, then saves it underneath the hoop to Texas. The flip up, no good for Moore. A chance for Faye is good.
And UConn right now is undersized inside, but their guards are trying. They're battling. Texas is just longer and hoppier and able to get those extra opportunities. It's hoppier a word.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I do. Brady wasn't hoppier, but knocked it in.
Perhaps happier.
I think so. Edwards hit the deck. Moore. It lasts in Connecticut. It'll stay here with Texas. We'll step aside. The Jimmy V Women's Classic. Remember, 100% of your donation goes directly to cancer research. Well, thank you very much. Well, a terrific start this afternoon for Rory Harmon, the leader of the Texas Longhorns.
Came into this game so confident, and she is going to run the show. They are running actions for it. Goes off the screen. I mean, what a great way to start for a player who hasn't shot the three-belt ball well this season is to hit it. That's her sweet spot, when she can get in the paint, because she can elevate and score, or when she draws the eyes of all the defense, can distribute to her teammates. She was telling us this morning, I've got to look for mine, and that opens things up for everyone else. And we've certainly seen that so far here today.
Also, she just worked so much on her game in the offseason. And she said, it wasn't just the individual work I did that made me more confident. It was the fact that I got everyone in the gym with me. She said, because when you're on the floor, you're not out there alone. You're out there as a team. And this has been a group that Vic Schaefer has absolutely loved coaching thus far this season.
And Rory talked about, you know, knowing her teammates, knowing where they like to get the ball, if they like to dribble the ball, so she can put them in a position to be successful.
Yeah, it was interesting just hearing her process as she thinks through. If I make this pass now, you seem open, but I know this player's about to be. As Booker hits another smooth jumper.
Man, this young woman is a delight.
Madison Booker up to 9 points. Here's the pressure from Texas. Nika Mule able to get free of Gonzalez. Here's Mule over to Griffin. Beckers in there with Mule, Brady, Arnold, and Griffin. Edwards getting a breather for Connecticut. Still 10 seconds to operate on the shot clock. Here's Mule, gets around Gonzalez, sets up Griffin. No. Becker's a hand on it, but Harmon blasts away with it for Texas. Harmon shovels Booker. Short. And Arnold and Brady combine and knock the rebound out of bounds. Texas ball. Hey, this is the 29th annual Jimmy V Classic Tuesday night on ESPN and the ESPN app. Number 13, FAU, takes on number 24, Illinois at 6:30 Eastern. And then number 17, North Carolina, squares off against number 4, UConn. Always a great night for a great cause. To donate to the Jimmy V Foundation, go to V.org.
UConn's Tristan Newton had an incredible 31-point performance in their loss to Kansas. That was a heck of a game to watch.
Hey, our friends Sue Bird and Jason Sudeikis were courtside at that game.
They were rooting for different teams.
That's right. And they were courtside yesterday in Iowa, a state we will be in Wednesday for Iowa-Iowa State on ESPN2 as the offensive foul is called on Arnold. That will be her second personal.
Taylor Jones has been out since she picked up her second foul, as we see here. KK Arnold getting in there. It's one of the staples of Texas and Vic Schaefer coach teams, as players stepping in to take the charge. And Gino Auriemma putting Aaliyah Edwards back in. I thought he might sit her the rest of the second quarter so she would not pick up her third.
Jack Alango, Mwenintanda took that charge. Edwards nearly came up with a steal there. Beckers went for it and picks up the foul. That'll be number one on Beckers. But Texas is already in the bonus as the fouls have piled up against Connecticut in this second quarter. The other thing we have seen, Rebecca, and this was a prime concern of Vic Schaefer's, that his team has done well, has kept Connecticut completely off the offensive glass. Connecticut has one offensive rebound in this first half.
Wow.
Texas, a really strong rebounding team. They enter this game third in the nation. Offensive rebounding rate, 10th in defensive rebounding rate.
They've got good size. They've got good depth at their post position. The guards will attack the boards as well.
And this is without Deanna Gaston, who was all Big 12 first team a season ago and is getting close to returning. You see Gaston, who there hasn't been a definitive date for her return set, but it's thought to be soon. Edwards, Griffin trying to save it, could not. It was just a little too much on that pass from Aaliyah Edwards.
Gaston, 12 points, 6 boards a game a season ago.
That's the 8th Connecticut turnover. The earliest date with 3 losses in program history for Connecticut, December 13th. Got to go back to 1986. Rebecca Lobo was a young pup.
I'm just glad it's not a team I was on.
Here's Booker. Bounces to the corner. Gonzalez. Penix on a three.
What a pass. What a pass.
I think that was to the scouting report from Vic Schaefer about Booker as a passing wing.
Yes.
A 12-point Texas lead. Connecticut has not led in this game. Texas got out to a 15-3 lead. Connecticut had cut it to five multiple times. No closer. And another turnover, number nine for the Huskies.
Really good job with the hard hedge by Texas. But here, dribble penetration coming baseline. I mean, look at that pass. A bounce pass to the corner where the defender almost had her foot out of bounds.
Mate, you could tell Madison Booker is special.
There's so many special freshmen this year.
It's so fun to watch. See what Juju Watkins is doing at USC. Malaysia for Wiley at South Carolina. That 3-2 strong from Gonzalez. Harmed in the rebound. Gonzalez drives inside. Flips it up wildly. Griffin comes away with it for Connecticut. Hannah Hidalgo at Notre Dame.
Kayla Williams, LSU. Let's keep going.
Let's keep going. Brady gets some separation, dumps it too tall for Aaliyah Edwards, and you can just see there's a lack of connectivity and accuracy with some of Connecticut's passes.
And so much of that is just because of the pressure that Texas has been putting on Connecticut, in particular when they're trying to throw it to the high post, say to reverse the basketball. You have to catch it a step out farther than you want to because of the denied pressure by the Texas bigs.
Sixth turnover of the quarter for Connecticut. Ice Brady will check out. Ashlyn Shade in for the first time this half for Connecticut. Another freshman who the Huskies are going to be relying upon. Here's Booker. We're going to break down. Gonzalez cutting through. Shade was there. And a foul is called on Shade. Free throws for Shaylee Gonzalez.
Trying to protect the paint when they go with a small lineup. Connecticut can go with their zone, but then there's potentially issues in terms of getting to the defensive glass.
Connecticut, remarkably, has shot it at 52% this half. You think about it, Rebecca, you're not going to see many halves where you shoot it at 52% and you only have 25 points.
14 fewer field goal attempts, not only because they've turned the basketball over, but on the offensive glass, Texas 9 old boards.
A 14-point Texas lead, an 8-0 Texas run.
Watch the hedge. Oh, rejects the screen.
Shade fakes the three, takes the two, knocks it down.
Ashley Shade is shooting 71% from the mid-range. That's her game.
Number 15 overall recruit this past season, a McDonald's All-American. Booker's jumper is smooth. It's really smooth.
And whether you're in a man or a zone, you have to know where Madison Booker is. Too dangerous.
Booker up to 11 points. Harmon has 14 points, 7 assists. Shade barrels in. That's a charge. Harmon taking the contact and another Connecticut turnover.
The hard deny by the guards allows for the backdoor cut. And so what do you do about that? You either have a shot blocker there or a player willing to take the charge. There's no restricted area for women's basketball this year except right under the cylinder, so it doesn't come into play there.
Shot clock turned off. Crowd at the Moody Center rising to its feet, applauding this first half effort. Remember, Texas has never beaten Connecticut, 0-10 all time. Harmon lets it fly. No. Rebound. Bounced around. Griffin has it and is fouled. Texas did have fouls to give.
Still don't want to give it there.
No. Ideally, no.
But you love the tenacity and going after the glass.
Point two remaining. That'll do it for the first half. Connecticut turns it over 11 times. against this Texas defense. And the Longhorns in the half on a 10-2 run. They have a 14-point lead on Connecticut. How about Vic Schaefer's Texas Longhorns, led by Rory Harmon, a 14-point lead as we send things to the studio. L and Steph. Welcome back to the Jimmy V Women's Classic presented by Corona. Number 11, Connecticut taking on number 10, Texas. Rory Harmon scoring or assisting on 30 of Texas's 41 points. And Aaliyah Edwards doing what she can for Connecticut with 11 points to lead the way for the Huskies. As we welcome you back courtside, Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. I want to remind you throughout this game, you can go to v.org/donate. 100% of your money goes towards cancer research here for the Women's Jimmy V Classic. Texas couldn't have had a better first half, and we saw another freshman enter the conversation, Madison Booker.
She's got an all-around game, especially on the offensive end of the floor. She's an absolute handful. At 6'1", she can create her own shot. We saw her step in to a smooth three off the dribble, can handle and score. And to me, this next one is her most impressive play of the first half. This is a tough pass. There's no angle. There's no real estate to get it there. She is still able to deliver it right on the money. What a first half for that young woman.
Take a look at those first half stats. You know, one of the key things is the field goal attempt difference because of the turnovers and then also the offensive rebounding of Texas. See, Connecticut turned it over 11 times in that first half. Texas a plus 13 in points off turnovers. And they also dominated the offensive glass. They held Connecticut to just one offensive rebound and had 9 themselves. So 15 more field goal attempts for Texas.
They from start to finish defensively, they've done their job. They've forced turnovers when shots have gone up. They've cleaned up the defensive glass. And limiting Paige Beckers to 5 field goal attempts is impressive itself.
Beckers comes up with a steal here. Well, I mean, think about this, Rebecca. Connecticut shot 54% in that first half. They're down by 14. Griffin comes up with an offensive rebound, just their second of the game, and then loses it out of bounds. There have been a couple of moments like that, too, just unforced errors.
And I did really like the field goal attempt by Paige Beckers,
yeah,
because she has not gotten many clean looks. She may have to channel some Caitlin Clark and come down a few times and just launch from deep. Yes.
Yeah. Vic Schaefer said he expected her to shoot 25 shots in this game.
Well, it's his defense that's prevented her from doing so.
Here's Harmon into the paint, elevates, and gets it to go. She's been able to elevate and contort her body so that she's always square as she's delivering.
She's 5'6". Nika Mule, who's defending her, is 5'10". And with her elevation, she's been able to get clean looks at the bucket.
And a whistle here is going to go against Booker. That will be the first personal on Madison Booker.
So Nika Mule stays between Harmon and the basket, contests, but no problem with the vision, no problem with the release.
Here's Griffin. Griffin, shuffle the feet, travels, and turns it over. So back-to-back turnovers from Aubrey Griffin. We told you about Texas. They are averaging a plus 13 per game in the turnover margin. Here's Muhammad going backdoor, laying it in off the delivery from Harmon. Largest lead of the afternoon for Texas. It has swelled to 18.
When Connecticut's gotten their backdoors, there's been a help defender there for Texas. That time, no help defense from Connecticut on Texas backdoor.
We showed you the stat earlier as Edwards gets inside of Jones and finishes. Connecticut, the earliest they have ever lost their third game of a season is December 13th. You have to go back to 1986. That is certainly in peril here today. That's a trap.
Connecticut trying to get out and deny. Aaliyah Edwards trying to deny and just backdoor Ice Brady there just a step too late. And to the stat on Connecticut in wins and losses in November, part of that
another
is a
turnover here.
Part of that is a reflection of the tough strength of schedule that they play every year.
Here's Booker behind the back, dips inside. That is a pro move for Madison Booker.
The 2027 draft is going to be nice,
oh,
isn't it?
Oh, my goodness. We've seen plenty of WNBA teams in attendance for this game. Sure, they're liking what they're seeing from Madison Booker, just knowing they're going to have to wait a little while.
I mean, 6'1", again, we've talked about her frame here. Behind the back, deftly step, just step through, squares, floats it up and in.
Edwards falling away, draws the foul. You know, you think Booker, she wears that 35, that Texas 35, pretty nicely, doesn't she?
Who else wore a Texas 35?
You know, there was a guy here at Texas who wore 35. He had a pretty solid career. Might be hanging from the rafters now. One Kevin Durant.
Taylor Jones just picking up her third foul, and she's had a couple ticky-tack ones. I feel for her when the big player, you just want to be out there on the floor working hard, and there it is.
There's that 35 for KD.
Oh, how young he looks.
I know. Just moved into 10th place on the NBA's all-time scoring list. Point Texas lead. That three rounded off for Gonzalez. Jones on the bench with that third foul that Rebecca talked about. Here's Booker off the mark. Griffin the rebound.
Couple good looks at three though against that Connecticut zone.
Here's Mule, who has been quiet today. Nearly another turnover. Beckers threw four defenders, almost threw it away. Brady was just able to stay in the front court. Here's Beckers. Beckers shovels it up and in, and Paige Becker is just creating chicken.
That was incredible. That was an incredible move.
I think you know the rest.
Oh, salad. I gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Out of bounds, going to stay here off the deflection with Texas.
All right, so what do we got at first? We got one thing, and then now we got the chicken salad, Ryan Rucco, and the floater, because that was a nice contest as well.
And to your point, Rebecca, this just may be the kind of game where if Connecticut wants to have a chance, Paige Becker's just going to have to do some of that.
And while she's incredibly capable of it, she would rather get her teammates involved.
Booker, wow. Madison Booker putting on a show. 15 points for the freshman. Her and Harmon have been terrific leading Texas. Out of bounds, going to stay here. No whistle against Edwards. It'll be Connecticut basketball.
So the first time, on the exact same move, she got Aubrey Griffin to take the pump fake and step through. That was the exact same looking move, but this time just straight up and smooth with it.
And think about it. This is a Texas team that has the number one recruiting class in the nation for 2024. Edwards able to lean into a whistle there against five. And Aaliyah Edwards will go to the line.
And the number one recruit in 2025 was here watching practice this morning.
Yes. It's going to be the third foul on Fi as Arnold comes and get Griffin. Well, and you can see, Rebecca, Gina Auriemma is still trying to figure out what is the combination of five that is going to give him the kind of flow and continuity he's hoping for.
And teams that can give them trouble are teams that have depth and size inside, who can really rebound, who can pressure defensively at the guard spot. And certainly we saw that with NC State. We see that here again with Texas.
Connecticut still in that zone. Booker. Muhammad Five to shoot. Needs help. Harmon will pull. Short on the three. Rebound gobbled up by Muhammad. Couldn't get the putback to drop. And then Edwards directs it to Beckers, who has it knocked away. Harmon waits, dishes, and the finish from Bai on the interior. Nine assists now for Rory Harmon to go with their 16 points. Timeout, Connecticut.
Texas is going to pick you up full, and they're going to try to be disruptive here. The poke from behind ends up with a nice dish and the easy two.
Texas having a big afternoon here against Connecticut, and Madison Booker, the freshman, has been electric.
It certainly helps when you have a player who can go get her own shot against tough defense, right to left crossover. Paige Beckers, 5'11", good reach, is right there to contest. This time, right to left, step up and through. Aubrey Griffin, outstanding defender, simply doesn't matter. Once again, right, left, pull up, tough shot. Booker has been so incredibly compressive on the offensive end.
At 6'1", doing all of this with obviously a lot of size, just a very impressive freshman. And Connecticut struggling to find its footing here against Texas. They've taken 20 fewer field goal attempts than Texas, thanks to their turnovers and the offensive rebounds from the Longhorns. Here you go. Another Connecticut turnover.
Really good job by Texas. Help side defense just sitting off perimeter players, getting hands on the on Aaliyah Edwards' dribble.
16 Connecticut turnovers now. Remember, Texas forces 25 a game. Here's Muhammad bouncing inside. Five, good position, just couldn't finish the layup.
That's such a difficult set to defend as a post player, the post-to-post screen at the elbows.
Beckers trying to shake Harmon, couldn't. Rory Harmon has done a really nice job staying with Paige Beckers today. Brady lays it in, but a foul before the basket after a gorgeous pass from Aaliyah Edwards. Timeout on the floor. We will see you there Wednesday, 7 Eastern on ESPN2. Caitlin Clark in Iowa taking on Iowa State. And Caitlin Clark on her march to 3,000 career points, just 22 points shy. So you certainly anticipate it's going to happen on our air on Wednesday. And as far as tracking goes with game log, she would become the fastest since we have tracked to get to that 3,000 point mark.
There's a chance that she might get it in the first half.
She could.
Probably not the first quarter, but she could.
That kind of special. Not off the table. Looking forward to that. Beckers immediately surrounded. Trying to shake by. Beckers bangs in and gets the whistle. And Paige Beckers in some pain after slamming into five.
We saw Connecticut run that play in the first half as well, posting up Rory Harmon with Paige Beckers. But you're right, whether it's been on the perimeter or that time at the post, when she has the ball in her hand, she is getting a ton of attention.
That is the fourth foul on Hadijah Fye. So she will check out. Aaliyah Moore into the game for Texas. We talked with Paige Beckers earlier today about the injuries to Connecticut. Daisy Fudd out for the season. Caroline Ducharme out as well now. Mentioned a couple injuries in the front court, which you see with Jana Alfie out for the season, Anna Patterson. And she said going through last season and missing the entire season actually has helped her to deal with this, because she's been able to maintain a gratitude just to be on the floor playing. And it's allowed her to stay optimistic about what this group can turn into, even if it's going to take some time. Here's Booker. Out to Gonzalez. Booker storms inside. Can't bank it in. Good contest from Brady. Connecticut controls a 15-point Texas lead. A reminder, Texas has never beaten UConn. Connecticut 10-0 all time. Here's Beckers. Lost her footing. Got it to Brady. Arnold finds Beckers. Clean look is good. Maybe the best look Beckers has had all afternoon. And, of course, she drills it. And Connecticut make a little push here at the end of this third. Moore facing up, bodying in, and it's stripped. Here comes Beckers. Paige Beckers, the no-look dime, and Edwards lays it in. Seven straight points from Connecticut.
And they have been able to rebound out of the zone, which has allowed them to go the other way and get some scores, but it's got to start with stops.
Here's Harmon, a little too strong. Beckers the rebound. And Connecticut trying to build something here at the end of this third. Beckers directing Mule to the other side of the floor. Beckers into the paint. Scoop shot, too strong. Couldn't finish it, got to the rim. Now Booker, the pull-up is true. Madison Booker up to 17 points.
How is that kid only averaging 10.8 a game?
Crazy to think about as the home run pass goes out of bounds from Mule. Another Connecticut turnover.
Paige Beckers is trying to do things, and on the offensive end, goes down, gets bumped. Yeah, just gets back up, steps into an open look. Continues to work hard.
17 turnovers for Connecticut. Here's Harmon. She got it on a three, and a nice response from Texas after Connecticut had scored seven straight.
And that's the one area of Harmon's game that you look at and say, you know, that's where she needs to improve, is to be more efficient from three. She has been today.
Yes. Two of four from downtown today. That ball wedges off. Booker pushing pace. Harmon changing direction. The deep seal. Moore gets denied by Brady. Saved inbounds, and Arnold has it off and running for Connecticut. Mule to Beckers, who scoops it off. The follow won't go from Brady. It's knocked out of bounds and stays here with Connecticut.
And Rory Harmon, coming into this game, was 3 of 13 from 3. Steps into that one with supreme confidence.
About 19 points, 10 assists, 5 rebounds for Harmon.
Paige Beckers getting a blow right now. I thought Connecticut was looking a little bit tired the last couple of minutes. Understandably, only going 7 deep today.
Arnold can't finish, but a whistle. And Arnold is going to shoot two.
One other thing to add to that Harmon line, she has just one turnover, which is exactly how things have been this season for Rory Harmon.
It's kind of a lot for her in a game.
Yeah. She now has 70 assists and 9 turnovers of the season.
She's averaging one turnover a game.
Yes.
It's ridiculous.
Incredible. Arnold hits the first. Rory Harmon talked about her goal being to get this team past the Elite Eight. Said, we set end goals, but then we don't talk about them. Our goal is really just to win practice each day and stack good practice habits, and that is always a trademark of Vic Schaefer's teams. Here is Booker across her body, pushed it right. Muhammad, another offensive rebound, and draws the foul.
And that time, Connecticut was in a man-to-man, and Muhammad just attacked the offensive glass.
Muhammad with 5 offensive rebounds this afternoon. And Texas, a 13-4 edge on the offensive glass. As Muhammad hits the first. Connecticut is still shooting over 51% from the floor. But Texas has 23 more field goal attempts.
as Beckers checks in for this final possession of the third.
And this terrific performance from Texas has basically been without Taylor Jones on the floor because of foul trouble.
That's right. And with Deanna Gaston coming soon for Texas.
Look at Ahmed.
Wow, look at this. Ahmed takes it away. Harmon flips it ahead. Gonzalez lays it in. Beating the clock. To the fourth quarter we go.
Smothering defense is Texas's calling card. Amina Mohammed, the 6'4 big, able to help get the steal, leading to two easy ones the other way. Turnover's the story of the game.
The classic here in Austin. A reminder that 100% of your donations go directly towards cancer research. You go to v.org/donate. Texas, a 17-point lead. Turnovers, you said it, partner. That has been the story. Take a look at the difference of turnovers and points off turnovers. That's why Texas has a 17-point lead.
And their incredible performance on the offensive glass as well, where they have 13 to Connecticut's 4. They have 24 more field goal attempts than UConn.
Rebecca, you and I were just talking off air in the break about this Texas team. As we begin the fourth quarter, Nika Mule gets a shot up finally and hits the three. This is a Texas team that could make a lot of noise this season. They absolutely could be a Final Four team.
Without question. I mean, you're watching them today, and this has been their real first test of this early part of the season. And say, all right, what's their weakness? Well, coming into the game, the eyes home by Booker, right to left. You can't let her go right to left. I don't know what their weakness is. Coming in, you'd say maybe it's three-point shooting, but they've made just enough of them today when they've been open. Booker's hit them. Rory Harmon's hit them. Gonzalez, we know, can hit them. I mean, again, here, face up. I mean, just the poise, the quick jab step right to left. No one's been able to stop that.
Young career high, 19 points for Madison Booker.
You say, how does she only average 11 a game? Well, she's only played 21 minutes a game because Texas has beat their opponents so handily up to this point.
But to your point, Rebecca, if they can hit enough threes like what we've seen today, and then you add in just the way they rebound and the way they turn opponents over, they're so disruptive that they play close games by nature.
And even if they can't hit those three, they get so many more field goal attempts and get to the free throw line usually more than their opponent. That makes up for it.
...62-48, Texas in front. Early fourth quarter action. A reminder, Texas has never beaten UConn. 0-10 all time. Arnold nearly came up with a steal. Instead, Harmon gets space, jitters into the paint, floats it in. 21 points for Rory Harmon. A new season high as Beckers gets banged to the ground on the other end. Well, Connecticut on the road against top 10 opponents. Their last four road games have been losses. And today, trending in that direction as well. Beckers hits the first. So the other thing to keep in mind with Connecticut is not only are they trying to piece this together now without some key members of their starting lineup, their rotation, but so Beckers is still coming off a major knee injury. As Moore lays it in, missed all of last season, and you're asking her to take on an even larger load as she acclimates back to this level of competition. 17-point Texas lead. Edwards splashes free and lays it in. 20 points for Aaliyah Edwards, who's 8 of 9 from the floor. Harmon gets fouled in the backcourt by Arnold. That'll be number three on KK Arnold.
Just running out in transition, handling the ball well, cutting to the basket, unselfish. Great pass by Booker with her head up. She leads the break.
Moore checks out. Jones comes back in. Booker has four assists to go with her 19 points. Harmon has 11 assists to go with her 21. Dumps it down in traffic. Jones surrounded and a whistle. Going to keep things here. And coming up, 5 Eastern on ESPN, the third and final game of the 22nd annual Women's Jimmy V Classic. Number 16, Ohio State, taking on number 20, Tennessee. To donate to the V Foundation for Cancer Research, go to V.org. 100% of your donation goes directly to cancer research.
That's a game where the Lady Vols are going to have to take care of the basketball. Ohio State's averaging 29.5 points off of turnovers.
Ashlyn Shade in for Connecticut. Got some minutes at the end of the second. Caden Samuels in as well as Booker missed that one badly. Jones trying to save it. Could not. First game of our triple header today. Duke gave South Carolina a scare, had a nice comeback in the third, but a big fourth quarter from the Gamecocks, and they remain undefeated and number one in the nation.
We've got quite a triple header.
Wow.
Next weekend.
How about that?
South Carolina goes against Utah. That'll be fascinating. Our game earlier this season, Utah made 22 threes.
UCLA plays that day.
Against Florida State. And we got Connecticut against North Carolina.
Arnold lays it in. Tough finish through the contact for KK Arnold.
This game's still within reach.
Yeah.
For Connecticut. If they can get some stops, defensive boards, get some decent looks the other way. You wonder how long Paige Beckers will stay on the bench.
Harmon, Arnold. Comes in with a steal as Harmon was directing traffic. Shade gets ahead and lays it in. KK Arnold bringing a little energy on the defensive end, and now Texas needs a timeout.
Texas has done such a good job all game long, getting steals and scores the other way. Well, KK Arnold says we're going to give you a little of your own medicine, saves the hoop. Ashlyn Shade out for two. We got an 11-point ball game.
All right, El, we look forward to that. Meanwhile, Connecticut on a 6-0 run have shown signs of life here in this fourth quarter. Texas an 11-point lead. 6:47 to go in this fourth quarter. And with Paige Beckers on the bench, KK Arnold has caused some disruption on the defensive end and sprung a couple of easy buckets for Connecticut.
Three freshmen on the floor right now for UConn. Coach Oriema sticking with the group. That's helped him go on this little mini run.
Arnold, Shade, and Samuels, the freshman, out there with Edwards and Nika Mule. Here's Harmon. He just turned it over for just the second time today. Booker. Booker fading and hit, but gets the foul against Samuels. And Madison Booker is going to the line to shoot two.
She's a pretty good option, right?
Yeah.
When the offense isn't quite getting you something easy, just get it in Booker's hands.
You better go to work. They're calling out the
mop.
Mop, yeah.
Is a round mop more effective than a long mop?
I always hesitate when I call it a mop because it looks nothing like the kind of mop you would use.
I mean, it's cute and all, but is it more effective than the traditional mop?
It probably is. Now, we've talked about that number 35 in Texas. How about Madison Booker?
KD. Yeah. From that same wing.
You're right. The 35. She's wearing it well.
That's right. That silky smooth jumper off the dribble. Here's Shade on a three. She got it. Ashlyn Shade pumps her right fist. And it is a single-digit deficit now for Connecticut. Here is Booker, who has 20. Gonzalez falling away, can't get it to go. Samuels the rebound. Here comes Connecticut. Arnold with a lot of space. Arnold into the paint, backs away and travels. He had a two-on-one in the paint, and Gina Orianda saying, go up with it, go up with
Especially
it.
Especially because Aaliyah Edwards had the defender on her back, holding her off so that she could go right in. Look at Aaliyah Edwards holding Jones off, and just needed to explode up. I would like to see Texas go back to that big-to-big screen on the elbows. Connecticut was having a tough time defending that.
19 turnovers for Connecticut. Muhammad lays it in. Good position on the block, and Harmon found her.
Yeah, really well-delivered basketball by Harmon.
12th assist for Harmon. Lead is 11 for Texas. Will Connecticut get another chance as good as the one they just had? Edwards knocks in the jumper. Aaliyah Edwards with 22 points. She's 9 of 10 from the floor. Paige Beckers continues to sit. Gina Auriemma riding this group that has been working. Now Beckers goes to the scorer's table. Here's Harmon. Dumps it in. Jones fading and hooking it home. First points of the game for Taylor Jones.
Two possessions in a row with great looks from the Texas bigs.
Edwards, nice little give and go with Mule on the finish.
That was a spectacular pass from Aaliyah Edwards. You know I love my bigs who can pass, Ryan Rucco.
I do. Reminds you so much of your skill set. Here's Harmon, who has tied a career high with 13 assists. Working behind Booker. Three to shoot. Harmon's going to have to launches an air ball out of bounds. And here's an opportunity for Connecticut with Beckers checking back in.
Aaliyah Edwards catching the ball up high. I mean, she just drops that between three defenders. This is not an easy look. Beautifully, beautifully done.
Beckers came and got Arnold. Under 4 minutes to go. Here's Samuel's jumper. It's good. Connecticut has cut it to 7. Texas blasted out to a 15-3 start, and Connecticut has not been closer than 5 since, and it has been a while since they were within 5. Muhammad on the drive gets whacked and falls hard to the wood. She will shoot two.
Aaliyah Edwards comes over on the help side and kind of swings at the block shot. Muhammad so explosive going, just falls hard. I think it's fair for the officials to go take a look at this. Mostly because of the nature of Aaliyah Edwards swinging with her arm.
Could potentially upgrade this to an intentional foul, which of course is, if you're more familiar with the pro game, the wording on what you would call flagrant in pro basketball.
And so watch Aaliyah Edwards' arms. This, to me, is what makes it the nature of it. The right one kind of comes down, and I think that's what catches Muhammad's arm and makes her fall. Oh, no, it's actually Samuels from behind.
And it was Samuels who was actually whistled for the foul.
I might upgrade that. again, because of the nature of the arm kind of swinging right here, coming down and then pulling down again. And it's such an incredibly hard fall.
All they have to determine is that there's unnecessary contact here in order for it to be upgraded to an intentional foul, which is two shots and the basketball.
The call on the floor will remain a common foul on four from UConn.
Wow, okay. It remains a common foul, so just two free throws here for Amina Muhammad, who is 63% from the line on the season. She is 2 of 2 today. Muhammad, the sophomore, who was a part of the Big 12 all-freshman team last season, has sparkled, filling in for the injured Deanna Gaston. And hits the first free throw.
And we just saw her explosive on the offensive end of the floor, but I've been even more impressed with her on the defensive end. And Vic Schaefer talking about how she can guard 1 through 5, and we've seen it multiple times out on the perimeter, her making a difference.
8-point game, Connecticut basketball. Still a lot of time left. Backdoor, Samuels gets free and lays it in. It is a 6-point game. Connecticut is trailed by as many as 18 in this second half.
Texas, I like the matchup with Booker having Nika Mule defending her.
Connecticut trailed by 17 after three quarters. Mule fell down trying to hang with Booker. Here is Booker, the jab step, the jumper, too strong. Jones, the putback won't go. Rebound knocked around, and it last hit Connecticut. It's going to be Texas basketball.
Booker crashed the boards from the perimeter, and that's the reason that the ball got hit and got went out of bounds, and it retained by Texas.
A reminder that Texas is 0-10 all-time against Connecticut. A chance to change that today. Booker left alone, can't hit. Becker's the rebound. Connecticut with a real opportunity now. Samuels on the drive to the corner. Becker's into the paint. Edwards gets bumped, no call. Edwards looking for a whistle and didn't get one. A lot of contact on Aaliyah Edwards. But no foul called, and Connecticut turns it over. Their 20th turnover of the day.
How are you supposed to keep your balance if somebody pushes your legs? I am stunned that that wasn't called a foul.
Same. Just the second turnover of the quarter for Connecticut. Texas running clock here. 4 seconds to shoot. Harmon trying to get some space and gets the whistle against Ashlyn Shade. Rory Harmon is going to shoot two.
So we'll take a look end to end on one end of the floor here. Aaliyah Edwards with the basketball. Oh, you know what?
Looked like she bodied into her pretty good at the beginning of that. And I think Shade just hits the wrist of Harmon, which is enough there to be a foul. I'm going to say correct call on Shade, incorrect non-call on the other end.
Okay.
Harmon knocks in both free throws. 23 points, 13 assists, 5 rebounds for Rory Harmon. Vic Schaefer says over and over again, she is the best point guard in the nation. She has played like it this afternoon. Backdoor, Arnold lays it in. 6-point game. Connecticut applying some pressure. Harmon sending ahead Muhammad, flings it across to Gonzalez. Now Texas is going to wind that clock. Hey!
Harmon being guarded by Arnold. Five to shoot. Harmon gives it up to Booker. Three to shoot. Booker, the fadeaway off the mark. Rebound knocked around. Texas has it. And the putback for Muhammad. Another key offensive rebound from the Longhorns.
All credit to Taylor Jones, who tipped that ball to keep it alive.
Mule is fouled on the drive. It's going to stay here, but the foul is actually going to be underneath against Jones, who was jockeying with Edwards. Here was the 16th offensive rebound of the afternoon for Texas.
Yes, and just a little bit of a reach by Jones to keep that alive so a teammate can corral it. We saw that a lot from the New York Liberty in the WNBA this season. You can't get it, just keep it alive for a teammate.
Nonquil Jones, Brianna Stewart using their long arms, and a turnover here. Mule whistled for the offensive foul. And a timeout taken by Connecticut.
Nika Mule trying to get open. A little bit of a push. Nice job by Gonzalez to get the call.
21st turnover for Connecticut. Rebecca, we talked with Vic Schaefer earlier today. He was very honest. He said, this is going to be by far and away the toughest test we've had yet this season. Was anxious to see the way his group responded. And Rebecca, not just the way now Texas has responded overall in this game, but how they've responded to the Connecticut run here, too, in the fourth quarter, doing just enough to have this game in hand.
Texas came out and threw the first, four punches or so, and they did a great job keeping this crowd involved and kind of establishing themselves in this game. And, yes, Connecticut has continued to make runs, and there have been answers and hustle play answers by Texas, whether it's getting the steals or keeping the offensive glass alive. And I'll say this about UConn. There have been times today where they've made mistakes, turned the basketball over, maybe not boxed out the way Coach Oramo would like them to, but they've continued to compete. They've continued to have fight. They've continued to work hard. Might in this game be a matter of they don't have the horses.
But maybe it's something they can build upon moving forward. And here is the fourth quarter for Connecticut. How about that shot chart? 10 of 10 in the fourth quarter from the floor. They've actually, as a team, this is incredible, Rebecca. They've shot it at 63% as a team. But they've just turned it over 21 times and allowed 16 offensive rebounds. So Texas has taken 27 more field goal attempts than Connecticut. And a foul here applied by Connecticut with Texas in the bonus.
And smart. Coming into this game, Rory Harmon only 50% from the free throw line, 9 of 18 on the season.
She is 3 of 4 today. And her being a little more efficient from three and from the line feels essential for Texas to elevate to the heights they're capable of. Today, she's done that.
And essential for Rory Harmon. That completes her as a player. Those were the two areas, free throw line and threes.
And she calmly knocks down both. Texas lead is back to 10. Under 45 seconds to go. Beckers will take the long two. Can't hit it, Booker. Wow, that is a dangerous pile with four players involved and Harmon at the bottom of it. Ooh, that is the last thing you want to see right now if you're Vic Schaefer, is Rory Harmon being pancaked at the bottom of the pile.
But certainly the effort to go get the rebound is something you do like, yes.
All cosmetic at this point. Arnold can't scoop it in. Banged around, loose on the floor. Jones dives for it. Texas has the possession arrow. And the shot clock turned off. See if Connecticut backs off with 24.8 to go and Texas leading by 10. This will be the earliest in program history that Connecticut has reached three losses.
Previously, it was December 13th of 1986. Gino Auriemma hadn't even sent a recruiting letter to Rebecca Lobo yet.
Connecticut hopeful that they will get Ayanna Patterson back, hopeful that they will get Caroline Ducharme back, which will give them depth in the post, will give them depth in terms of their guard spot and three-point shooting.
.5 to go in this fourth. Rory Harmon a chance to add to what has already been an incredible afternoon. 26 points, 13 assists. And Harmon has knocked down her free throws, too, when it's mattered most.
Solid. She's just had an incredibly solid game.
7 of 8 from the line now. 15 seconds to go. Edwards can't hit. Harmon dashes ahead. Connecticut will back off. And for the very first time, Texas has beaten UConn. The 11th meeting, the charm for the Texas Longhorns. 80-68, the final, in a very impressive performance from Texas. And Connecticut, the earliest date they have had three losses in program history. Rory Harmon with 27 points, 13 assists. Booker, the freshman, with 20 points. And our final score, Texas 80 and Connecticut 68. For our producer, Kerry Callahan, our director, Mike Roig, the Hall of Famer, Rebecca Lobo, I'm Ryan Rucco. Time to tune over to ESPN for Ohio State against Tennessee as we say good afternoon from Austin.